Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of Botb. We got a Dreamcar competition winner yesterday, guys, for the RS7. It's a great win, guy, but his reaction was a little bit off for me. Maybe it is too much for him to handle. Different people react in different ways, but really happy for this win, guys. You know, it's a superb car. Alright guys, as I told you in my previous video, I gave a rectangular box towards down in this way, and that's where I actually played all my four tickets, including the free one. So my closest ticket was 1497498. It is one of those days, guys. There was a judge who mentioned that if this guy is gonna look steep, the head has to be tilted little back to the left. That's exactly what I mentioned in my video as well. That's the reason I didn't go too steep in this picture and opted to go a little bit right and down. I went right because of this guy's eyelining. I don't know. For some reason, the judges went a little bit left. I didn't play much tickets on this picture because, you know, the first thing is, like, a lot of people will be hitting the same area, and the chances of winning this is very slim. And also, I want to keep the fun in playing BOTB. Like, I have seen some people, you know, going crazy about BOTB, thinking that they will win BOTB if they play 30 or 50 tickets of high price cars. Guys, what you need to understand is that this is BOTB. It's same like a lottery. The only difference with the lottery and BOTB is we have the control in our hand to make our chances better, whereas in lottery we just take a number and hope for the best. I have seen in social media that so many guys are crying for a win, you know, like, I am having so much problem in my life, I need a win and all the stuff. Come on guys, BOTB is not your life, it's just an option, you know, for your luck to be worked in someday, and it's just an extra thing that will add an amazing experience to your life and give a boost to your life. It doesn't mean that BOTB has to give a win for you, since you are playing it for like number of years, like 10 years or 11 years. It's not the case, guys. Like, people complaining about playing for 10 plus years and spending a lot of money for great cars, and people who play for Jimny, they win the prizes in like 1 or 2 months playing. Guys, try to understand, Jimny or any lower category cars are in the dream car lineup for a reason. If you think this is not a dream car, then BOTB doesn't have to add up that car in the lineup in the first place. And people who play for the lowest cars, they have more chances than you people playing for the higher cars. Because if you play for Lamborghini Urus, you can play about 10 to 15 tickets and it will easily add up to £100. Whereas the person who is playing for the Jimny, he adds up just 20 tickets and maybe he's paying about £20 or £25. For me, guys, that's a very sensible way to play this game. Like, if you have won something from BOTB, like about a Jimny will come with 10,000 cap plus cash, or if it is in the dream car, it will add up another 20,000. So that's a big amount. If you win 30,000 or 20,000 from BOTB, in the future when you play, you know that you have won something from BOTB, so you don't hold yourself back going again to play a lower car because you have already won it from BOTB. So in that case, you might go for a higher end car. So stop this thing which is going on social media, guys. It doesn't look nice, you know. A person wins a car in BOTB, either it is a Lamborghini Urus or a Jimny, it's a win, guys. Appreciate it and, you know, just move on. It's just a request from you guys, you know. Like, when I see those kind of comments and messages, I feel really sad. Anyway, guys, let's quickly jump into where I played in the dream car. These were the linings I did in the dream car. It was really carefully taken on a high-res picture. This is the box I said I am gonna play in this picture, and you can see all my tickets were inside the box. and the winning area was not that far. But for me, the judging would have been much better given the circumstances, because two guys, I don't know, they went low in this area, and surprisingly it was only one guy taken out. If they are going to take out the lowest guy, the other guy was not that far away from that guy. In my opinion, guys, I think if they are going to take out one person, they should take out both. Finally, guys, I still think that this guy is not looking into his left. He's definitely looking into his right. But it is what it is, guys. We move on to the next. Okay, let's have a quick look at the judging this week. This is what I meant, guys. These two guys were lower and the other four were on the top part of the picture, and nobody was surprisingly in the middle, where in the end of the judging everyone was adamant that, you know, the average shouldn't be in this area. If we move the silver guy, that's a better coordinate. And if we move, they didn't even try to take out the orange guy to see where the average lands, but they were all discussing about the average being in the center is the best possible area. But if they are going to keep both of them in the picture, they wouldn't be taking the computerized average. They might move it manually away. So this is the only beef I'm having with the BOTB judging. If they are so adamant, once they get the average, that this average should be in this area, not a higher or not lower, why didn't they play their coordinates in that particular area in the first place? Why do you have to argue with everyone that this is the area they should be once the average is up in the screen? That's the only issue, guys. Otherwise, it's okay. Average wise, I don't have any complaints, but it could have been better. Hope for better results tomorrow. So without further ado, guys, let's jump into the midweek. Alright, guys, it's an interesting midweek picture we have, because I don't know whether the editing in this picture has been off, brick wall kind of a thing in the background. I analyzed this picture very carefully, guys, because, you know, like this guy's eye lining, I think the green one's line is in this direction. Like, my linings were done in a high-res picture, guys. Like, if you know what I mean, like, this is the high-res picture zoomed in, and you can clearly see the black pupil in his eye. Head is already tilted to the left, so the ball cannot be in a direct line. It has to be a little higher up. Let me tell you what I think about this picture, guys. What's going on in this, in my point of view. Checking his head position and the eye, the ball seems to be a bit in the background, it's not in the foreground, and this red guy is clearly winning the ball. And I drew up my linings mainly based on the red guy, since he's the winner, and this guy, the green one, is just looking at the ball. People might think it's a header or something this guy is going to head, but I think differently, guys. I can see some kind of a tension in his neck, like he's squeezing his neck with his shoulder, you know what I mean. If the ball is coming in this direction, he would definitely head it, but I think the ball is coming in this way. From the background, he's trying to jump up and chest it down. It's 100% chest down. The way his body language tells me that he's jumping up to chest the ball down, maybe in this direction. That's why this left hand is higher than the right hand. If you have played football, you know, these kind of situations are like, it's normal for a striker or a defender to get the ball chest down. So it's definitely a chest down for me. I won't be going higher up in this area. With that note, guys, I lined up the green guy's eye lining in this way. I did so many linings before I came to one line and stick to it. This is the direction for me. I don't know what you think. Please let me know in the comments if you think otherwise. Now to the interesting theory in the picture is, people might think that the ball is coming in this high, but for me in the high res picture I can see clearly see that he is looking in this direction, because if he is going to chest down the ball has to be further to the left. So I think if the judges are gonna do a fantastic job in this picture, guys, it has to be left, not to the right. Let's see how it goes, but I don't want to play in different areas. This is where my gut says the ball is, so I'm going to stick to my guts and play about 10 tickets and see where it takes me, guys. You guys are not forced to follow my exact area. I'm just giving this could be a possible area if I show you the zone. This is a 78 by 78 pixel box, guys. That's exactly the size of the zone 1 area. So if I'm going to play my tickets and want to be in zone 1, the lining looks pretty decent to me. Like if you put a ball here, right in the center, guys, I will show you zoomed out picture. So this is my prediction, guys. This is the area, and if the real ball is in the picture, it should be in this area as per my point of view, guys. You know, it can be different a person to person, but this is where I think, guys, the ball will drop to his chest. He might be jumping up, so if the ball is in this distance, it makes sense for him to chest the ball down, guys. So guys, for the midweek picture, my average for the possible zone 1 area is x1870 to 1958 and y910988, exactly 78 by 78 pixel, guys. It's a box of the size of the zone 1 area. I'm trying to do my best in my videos to give you the possible areas to play, and to be precise, that this is exactly a 78 by 78 box. I hope that this improves our winning chances in BOTB. Alright guys, I'm gonna wrap up this video. I wish you all the best for tomorrow. As I always say, play till you think it is fun for you to play. Don't spend too much on this BOTB, because you know, if you lose, you will be depressed, or you will have so many things running in your mind, you know, like you will hate the winner, you will hate playing BOTB, you will start questioning about the judges and all the stuff. That's because you are putting all your money in BOTB thinking that you are going to win. It's not the case, guys. It's just a lottery, so play it for fun, and one day, who knows, it might be your day. As always, guys, if you like my video, please keep watching. Just a small request from you guys, because I spend a lot of time in creating these BOTB videos for you guys to watch. So if you think I'm doing a good job, please leave a thumbs up. I'm not asking you to subscribe or something, you know, like people think if they subscribe to my channel, because some people think that if they subscribe to a person's channel that they are paying out of their pocket. It's just the contents that we keep on posting on YouTube, and we do invest a lot of time from our life to create these videos and edit it and post it for you guys. So I would really appreciate if you could give at least a thumbs up for the work we are doing here. That's all I ask, guys. Enjoy the rest of the week. See you soon on Sunday with another result and another picture to discuss. Till then, take care. Bye bye.